Hey everyone, it's Wobby. Time for another edition of the Pick 6. We're outside the outdoor practice fields right behind me. That's where OTAs are going to happen. 10 of them during the offseason program. The first three are this week. Until then though, let's get to work and answer some of your questions. The first one comes from Charles in Brazil. When Dalvin Cook was healthy, Latavius Murray had very few touches per game. Why wouldn't this happen to Alexander Mattison? It would be a waste of a third round draft choice. Well, here's the good news on these two running backs. They're both three down running backs, so Mattison or Cook can be on the field in any situation. That's going to give the coaching staff some versatility and flexibility in how they use these two guys. Also, remember, Dalvin is the guy. He's the Vikings running back, and he's going to do really well for the Vikings this year, but it's nice to have another guy in the fold for depth purposes as well. Remember Jerick McKinnon? He was a third round pick. Was that a waste? No chance. You need as many good running backs as you can get. Question number two comes from Andrew in Saratoga Springs, Utah. I really like the Armon Watts pick. Even though he won't be a starter, do you think he'll get playing time this season? And do you see a starting job in his future? That's tough to say right now. We haven't seen a lot of Armon Watts quite yet. We hope to see a lot more of him in the offseason program, mini camp and training camp. And we also have a loaded defensive line, so it's going to be tough to crack that rotation. But I think Armon Watts will compete with guys like Jalen Holmes and Jahlil Johnson for reps and playing time this offseason. Question number three comes from Howard in Oregon. For the backup QB spot, who among Browning, Slaughter, and Mannion has the best immediate potential to step in and why? This is truly a wide open competition during the offseason. It's going to be fun to watch this unfold all the way through the preseason. Now, Sean Mannion has more time spent in the NFL. Kyle Slaughter, though, might have a little more familiarity with the offense, the terminology, and the players here. So it's going to be a fun battle to watch this offseason. And as I said, it's going to go all the way through training camp. The next question comes from Drew in Plainfield, Illinois. With the departure of Marcus Sherrills, who is in contention for being the primary return man for the 2019 season? Aha, another fun position battle to watch this offseason and training camp. I would point to Mike Hughes as one candidate. He did it last year for the Vikings and looked good doing it. So as long as he's healthy and able, I think he's a possible return man for the Vikings. After that, maybe some wide receivers like Chad Beebe or draft pick Dylan Mitchell. All those guys will be competing for time. Next question comes from Joe. When are the Vikings going to bring in competition for kicker Dan Bailey? Well, the Vikings might do that during the offseason program and training camp competition. But remember on Dan Bailey, 30 of 31 on PATs last season for the Vikings, 127 for 130 career PATs since it was moved back to a 33-yard try. So Dan Bailey, very sharp in that aspect of his game. And I think his field goal percentage will go up this year now that he's got a year under his belt working with Matt Weil, the holder, and long snapper Kevin McDermott. Final question comes from Paul in Seattle. Wouldn't you agree the Vikings should retire jersey number 84 in the name of Randy Moss? Come on, man. Well, is Randy Moss worthy of having his jersey number retired? Absolutely. The guy is a Hall of Famer, one of the greatest players in franchise history, but I think the practice of retiring jersey numbers is going to start to go away in the NFL. We only have 99 numbers to give out, and we have 90-man rosters during the offseason. So we'll find some other ways to honor these players, including putting them in the Hall of Fame and the Ring of Honor. Randy Moss is in both of those elite groups. That's going to do it for this week's edition of the Pick 6. Thank you for watching, and thank you for submitting your questions. Please continue to do so using the email address at the bottom of the screen. Maybe we'll see you in next week's Pick 6.